जहां लरजा है तेरी आवाज के साए तेरे होठों के.
It's been one of those times, a season of discontent. I've been feeling alone and adrift and doubting the choices which have made up my life. Days are still and restless. Not many answers blowing in the wind, are there, Bob? And I don't know about you, but when I'm not sure what I'm looking for, I look for, well, okay, love. You think it's an escape? Oh, come now. Let's just call it a little diversion from the more complicated questions about life.
After no action for ages, I meet this really attractive man. But we don't agree on a single political issue. What do I do? Forget him?
If you had asked me this question 10 years ago, I would have said yes, but today.
If she keeps waiting for the politically correct man, she'll have a long wait. Forever.
It's just that he's so romantic. Like, he called me at 2 a.m. to say he was thinking of me.
Romantic? I think it's highly inconsiderate.
He's so romantic. What does romantic mean? It's the same. Bullshit.
Any girl here for a hot chat?
We want to be treated like idiots, like bimbos, but we pretend we are not.
See, I know it's not the thing to say, but I really don't want to end up alone.
Is that the worst possible fate? Alone can mean different things at different times, no?
I don't know if anything can change the meaning of being alone. Aloneness is a state of mind which does not necessarily have to do with ideology, although...
If you obsess about ideology in a love chat room, I can see why you have a problem with romance.
Love? This is a feminist chat room, Fearless.
Huh? But it's cool. All you need is love.com.
So?
Girls, PM me for sexy chat.
Oh boy, what's a nice girl like me doing in a place like this?
You aren't a feminist.
I see you believe in the direct approach, which must make you one.
And you?
I don't know if I would call myself one. Too much of a label.
I don't get it.
If I call myself a feminist, it defines me. Not by my own definition, but other people's. Someone else decides what I am like.
Feminism is a process, not an identity or label. I won't be defined, I'd be described.
That's the philosophy, and I can relate to it. But in practice, doesn't it really become about joining a group and meeting agendas?
Groups are important for making change on a wider level.
But can you really change people by scolding them in groups?
Can you change them just by setting a good example?
Okay, one sec. Don't get me wrong. I understand I owe many of my freedoms and choices to feminism, and I believe in the principles.
But won't risk calling yourself one? What do you think you will lose?
That same freedom of thought, the freedom to be confused, to see things in many ways.
What's the difference between openness and merely keeping your options open?
Good old-fashioned cop-out.
Please, this is the black and white thing I mean. One difference of opinion and bingo, you're a hero or villain.
What you are saying is, feminism works for you. And that's enough. But is it?
You got me there. If I say yes, I'm selfish. If I say no, well, what's my choice then? Or will you punish me, Marxist Rusha?
Darling, I could spank you if you like.
Well, I have to go. Let's talk about this some more. Here's my email.
ये 150 का 4 है 200 का 4 है
अरे बाप रे
ये 150 का 6
Since yesterday's internet chat, there's a snake in my brain and it won't go away. It keeps asking, is it enough that feminism works for me? Is it enough? Yes, sir. Sometimes it seems fairly obvious. Life's a fish. And then you fry. I had plenty of questions already. I didn't need to think of life with a capital L or feminism with a big F. But here I am. And who am I? For now, I've borrowed an identity from a movie star who wore a mask so she could play at being herself. Fearless Nadia. Like her, I can come and go as I please, slipping through the categories other people establish. Free to be a version of me. And yet, Internet Junkie has gotten under my skin. Her questions mixing with my questions. Or maybe it's just me. But once you start looking, you can't stop seeing. Seeing, for example, that a man gets burnt alive for dancing with his friend. That some man says in the paper that no one has the right to eat what he doesn't approve of. Or that the film we all love to love is about three rich boys with sharp haircuts. And little things from last week come crowding in, like these kids I met in a college where I went to see a friend.
As a just a background thing, pom-poms. We have shown the pom-poms
some
in their hand.
Attraction towards the people, actually.
That's why we have kept the girls. Actually, we've gone through the film. As the Dil Chahta Hai, they are shown, no? As per that, we are gone.
The boys are saying that the girls are just going to be an attraction in the background.
No, we are, yeah. But then more attractive is the pom-pom. The whole dance lies in our pom-pom.
The steps with the pom-pom is more important.
What does this song mean to you?
Like, it is a new generation, so we have to show that we are new.
Previously, girls and boys never used to be so
dance
with each other, right?
Now
we are dancing with each other, talking,
enjoying ourselves.
There's nothing, no more difference left between girls and boys.
Equally treated.
Equally treated.
What's that place behind being equally treated called? The one where you aren't quite equally treated but can't put your finger on it. Once the questions start, they don't stop, do they? The how, the why, the what has feminism given me? A room of my own, a view, good enough for me. Something tells me I should leave well alone, or I might, you know, get involved. But it's too late to say curiosity killed the cat. Too late to ignore the questions and go on as if nothing happened. No, I don't have a questionnaire or an agenda. No plan. Except to follow some part of an idea called feminism as it has trailed through the world. See what kind of life it has made for itself. What it has come to mean for different people. Well, and so it is that I'm on my way. We've been seeing them all along from the corners of our eyes. Hints of the past in the streets of the city. Roads named after women who fought for freedom. From the British, from the Brahmins, from the patriarchs. For the right to be in schools, legislatures, boardrooms, to fly planes, to get safe abortions, to walk on the street with a naked face. It was always there in the back of things, a long and winding part of our history, feminism. Yes, maybe I didn't think about it so much because I didn't have to. Maybe that's just me. Maybe I'm actually surrounded. Maybe all these women going places, getting the job done, are thinking about feminism.
Feminism, equal rights, feminism, internet addiction. Am I normal? Feminism, feminism.
Okay, maybe not each woman. I'm talking to a friend. I say, I'm thinking of a project on feminism. And he says, oh, I have the perfect example for you. Kanchan Gowre. She's Bombay's first and only woman cab driver. Who better to prove that feminism has reached the woman on the street? And I think, that could be pretty cool.
Where are you going, Sabji? Sabji taxi? आपको गाड़ी तेज चलाना अच्छा लगता है?
देखो पैसेंजर जो बैठता है गाड़ी में पैसा इतना देता है अपने को, तो आहिस्ता आहिस्ता जाने के लिए तो नहीं बैठता ना, तो बस से भी जा सकते हैं या ट्रेन से जा सकता है।
पर आपको मजा आता है?
हाँ टैक्सी मतलब गाड़ी चलाना, तेज गाड़ी चलाना बहुत मजा आता है मेरे को। ये मेरी तस्वीर है।
बाप रे।
जब मैं टैक्सी लाइन में आई तभी ये ऐसी थी मैं, तो अभी मतलब ये ऐसी जब थी तभी देख के ही सब टैक्सी वाले बोलते थे ना ये क्या है हीरोइन गाड़ी चलाएगी खाली टाइम पास, मतलब एक एक डेढ़ साल करेगी। लेकिन आज के तारीख में यही टैक्सी वाले बोलते हैं कि साला हम लोग इतना कमा के मतलब इतना ये करके हम लोग खुद की गाड़ी नहीं ले सके, दूसरे की चला रहे हैं और ये औरत हो के इसने मतलब क्या हो गया? कहाँ जाने गए? कहाँ जाने गए? वडाला? वडाला नहीं, खाली आना पड़ेगा वहाँ से। हाँ नहीं वडाला जाने गए ना, खाली आना पड़ेगा, राजधानी का टाइम हो गया। भैया ये तो कुछ भी नहीं, इतने छोटे बाल मैंने बनाए थे ना, जब भी सब ऐसे मतलब पैसेंजर जो बैठता था ना पीछे से तो बोलता था चलो बॉस करके, मतलब ऐसा लगता था कोई आदमी ही बैठा है गाड़ी पे ऐसा। जब भी देखते थे ना मिरर से दिखता है ना कि नाक में नतनी है कुछ है, अलग सा आवाज़ की तरह से आ रहा है, तो फिर बोलते थे अरे, फिर झाके देखते थे।
ये जो यूनिफॉर्म आप पहनते हो
जी
वो तो मर्दों के लिए बना हुआ है?
तो मर्दों का काम तो कर रही हूँ ना मैं, तो उसमें से ही एक हो गई ना मैं भी। मैं खुद को ऐसे कहाँ समझती हूँ, जब भी गाड़ी पे आती हूँ तभी मैं एक लेडीज हूँ ऐसा नहीं समझती, कभी महसूस भी नहीं करती कि मैं एक लेडीज हूँ।
तो क्या आपको लगता है कि ऐसे काम करने से, दुनिया में बाहर निकलने से और वो काम करने से जो पहले मर्द ही करते थे, उससे औरतों का स्वभाव बदल जाता है, मर्दाना स्वभाव हो जाता है, क्या आपको लगता है ऐसा?
नहीं ऐसा तो कुछ नहीं, क्योंकि अभी मर्दाना स्वभाव क्यों बोलेंगे आप ऐसा, मतलब हर आज के तारीख में हर लेडीज काम कर रही है, 55% तो मेरे को लगता है कि बम्बई में लेडीज काम कर रही है, तो वो सब खुद को क्या मर्द थोड़ी ना समझती है। घर में जाके उनको भी देखना है, जैसे अभी मेरे बच्चे बड़े हो गए, नहीं तो मैं उसके पहले तो जाके देखती थी ना घर में जाके जब मेरे बच्चे ने कुछ खाया कि नहीं ये नहीं वो, तो वो हर औरत का काम है उसको तो करना है, वो तो पहला कर्तव्य बनता है उसका, घर देखना अपने हस्बैंड को देखना ये देखना।
आप ऐसा मानते हो तो अब आपके पति आपको घर रहने को कहेंगे तो आप मान लो?
नहीं रह सकती मैं अभी, मतलब कैसे, अभी उम्र के हिसाब से एक दो मतलब छुट्टियां ले सकती हूँ लेकिन घर में नहीं रह सकती मैं अभी।
इन द मूवी ऑफ देयर लाइफ डू वुमेन ऑलवेज हैव टू प्ले अ डबल रोल टू से just because I have a job, I haven't forgotten I'm a woman. I know my place. I know your place. Everything's changed, but nothing's changed. How do we move from defending ourselves in the world to conceiving how life could be different? I don't expect you to answer that, unless you have the answer, of course. Well, Miss Chumki, since you got me started on this inquiry, I'm duly informing you of its commencement. And this may not be the last you hear from me, because this is only the middle of the beginning.
So human body charts, right?
Yeah.
It's divided into, bifurcated into 10 different charts, starting from human ear, human eye, human brain.
I want different man and different woman chart.
That was not possible. I mean, the anatomy is same. There is only the sex organs which say this is a man, this is a female. That's what.
Otherwise, all are same.
Yeah. Human anatomy is same.
Sure.
Men and women, same, but a little different. Born that way, but separated at birth by a set of organs, brought together by the very same ones. Somewhere in the middle of this separation and joining, feminism, with all its big question marks, like, why is it easier to say fallopian tube than clitoris? Useful to know about reproduction, but not about pleasure.
It's not there in the syllabus yet, you can put it that way.
Who knows, maybe the syllabus has been waylaid in ancient bureaucratic corridors. Meanwhile, in the metropolis, surely life does move on,
And for people like us, with our easy freedoms and our modern marriages, is feminism even a question?
I really didn't want to do anything else but to get married after a certain point. It would give me some stability in life. There would be somebody to come home to, and there would be, you know, shared joys and shared sorrows. So.
I just thought that Chirish was that kind of guy who would really give me that kind of space, you know. If I wanted to do X thing, he will. And probably that's why I felt very comfortable, and he really complimented me. Like, you know, I'm like, honestly, you don't know this, but every day I don't tell you this.
But I'm like discovering something.
Probably I needed somebody who would really take care of me, because I have this tendency of like, you know, okay, now let me do. Because I said, yeah, I'm very independent, you know. But many times because of that very thing, you know, you go on the wrong track and you don't even realize that.
Given a choice, I'd rather not get somebody with me to lead her life with me who's extremely fiercely independent, who would keep her independence ahead of the unit that we form combined.
It's basically we comes first, then I, you know.
Right.
कहीं भी चले जाओ, अंदर से in heart of heart हर औरत जो बड़ी कहती है कि women's lip वाली भलाना ढिमका ये अंदर से वो भी चाहती कि ऐसा आदमी मिले जो मुझे tight रख सके. सिसी आदमी को औरत भी उसकी इज्जत नहीं करती. एक्चुअली जिंदगी में जो देखा जाए.
Which is something that I heard for the first time from her earlier once, and from her later.
Yes.
I had never thought of this myself. Actually.
नहीं, आज की लड़की भी यही
पसंद करती है. Yeah, I wouldn't respect a pansy on a sissy guy who has no, you know, backbone for himself. You know what I mean?
How do you describe yourself?
As I said, I'm independent and I like being that.
Can I just rephrase it for her though?
It is like I'm a person who wants my independence rather than saying that, you know, I am an independent person. There's a little bit of difference.
I should be valued as a person whose opinions matter, okay? And I should be given that right to live the kind of life I would like to, you know, live. I'm not saying that I'm a hardcore feminist because I really don't go out of my way to, you know, save a woman's life. Theek hai, hua hai. You know, it's bad. Women should not be treated this way. If something happens to me, I will definitely retaliate, you know, I'll not take it in. I'm not going to go 50 kilometers away to, you know, save somebody whom I'm saying that, yes, I am saying, but at the end of the day, probably not be able to do anything.
So you're incredibly selfish,
otherwise. I am selfish, yes, everybody is selfish, and I'm being...
Everybody is not selfish.
No, I would call people very selfish, who are feminists, who shout on top of their voices, go there, you know, tell 1,000 things to the lady, come
get
back,
the media
and...
footage and come back.
Yes, get the media footage and come back. Just burning bras is not really feminism for me, no. Yes, there's that big bra burning issue and stuff like that.
What was that?
But I really don't remember, I was like pretty small, but then we read quite a lot of stuff.
Why do you prefer the lacy pattern?
Obviously, for my husband.
Do you ever think of not wearing a bra?
No. Because I really feel comfortable with it. Like, I feel uneasy without it. What would you think of a woman who does not wear a bra?
I don't think she is a woman. In my opinion, each and every woman should wear this bra. It's good, otherwise it looks so odd, you know.
Oh,
Can there be smoke without a burning bra? What I love about the internet is, I only have to ask. So I discover the bra was never burnt, just thrown in a garbage can with other symbols of female subordination. A journalist reported it as bra burning. You can look up her reasons yourself. And it gets handed down as historical truth. Hi, here's a little urban legend that might interest you. Although, I still can't figure out why is burning a bra a problem. I mean, it's not like the national flag or anything, is it? Makes me realize how there is a lot most of us don't know and never learn, unless we go out looking. Although, is knowing the truth of things enough? Can you even know the real truth? Does knowledge change the shape of your life? Or do those decisions actually happen in other ways, more random, less conscious?
I understand you are a working wife. I have a few questions to ask. I hope you don't mind giving me the answers. Tell me, why you took the job in the first place and why you are still doing it?
In the beginning, it was because I was bored at home with nothing to do. And now I'm kind of used to it.
You're sure you didn't take the job because there wasn't enough money?
Well, there is never enough money.
Was it to get out of the home to avoid your mother-in-law or anyone else?
No. Luckily, I don't have any such...
Okay, I'm a feminist by my thoughts. But as far as my actions are concerned, maybe I can be one if I'm allowed to be one.
But can we remain like this at all times? At when we get married, we are dealing with another family totally. And we say, we can stand, it's a matter of choice. But how far can we withstand the pressure that comes from another family, a totally new lifestyle that's coming about? For how long can we say it is my choice, you know, I want to live life my way?
You just can't leave home. You just can't say, okay, get lost. I'm on my own now. It's not possible.
We have to think about the people who are going to come after us. Why are we in this state right now? Why do we have freedom to walk out at least at 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the night? Because there have been people in the past who have withstood these challenges. Only because of them we are what we are today. So if we don't break, if we say, okay, we give up, because how far can we fight? It's not going to make any change.
Hey, Fearless. Sorry for not replying earlier. Been busy with a conference on women, legal reform and policy formulation. After dozing my way through it, I think decisions about these things possibly happen in your sleep. I vote for subliminal education. Thanks for the website. I had no idea the bra wasn't burnt. What do you mean, what's the problem? You want women to walk around without a perfect shape and all unrestrained looking? That would make them very bad girls. Ah, Fearless, better mend your ways. Seriously though, it kills me how much stuff I don't know. If only I could get hold of one book that told me all. A Das Kapital of Feminism, you know?
When you don't know exactly what you are looking for, everything somehow seems relevant.
The only one?
I may need a better modus operandi than this, unless I get lucky, which I think I just did.
Okay, Rishi, it's a pleasure. Bye-bye.
Yeah, nice, thank you for coming by.
Why not?
Mainstream knowledge has always been, I think, male knowledge for one thing, because many of the theorists and writers have been male. In the hierarchy of knowledge, it has often been knowledge in English language, and it has often been knowledge generated in the West. So feminist knowledge created by women, has always been rather at the margins, pushing to be recognized. And I see what we are doing as that enterprise, you know. Not only pushing to be heard and recognized, but also pushing to change the nature of that knowledge. We thought we'd do academic research-based work, which would be either for the academic or the general reader. Then we would do fiction, because through women's writing you learn a great deal about women's experiences. And then we would use the money that we earned from these two things to subsidize what we called our activist pamphlets. And male and female sperm. So beautiful.
These are some of our authors in the early days we collected this. This is a woman called Lakshmi Kannan. Vandana Shiva, when she was very young. And this is a Pakistani writer called Nigat Khan. Kamla Bhaseen in the early days.
Oh my gosh.
This is one of the pictures from Bombay. This is a group that took a play all over Maharashtra. It was called the Stri Mukti Yatra.
Yes, Mukti
Sari. Yeah, that's right. This is in the... that's right.
Vacha is a women's resource center. It's part of women's movement. It has grown out of women's movement.
And what's the library also?
Yes, of course. It started as a library and a cultural center.
You have like detective fiction and stuff also.
We do, yes. Yeah.
How come?
Why not? It's women's writing. It's exciting. We are not here just for breastfeeding, right? We like detective fiction. Otherwise, why would people come? Then only these careerist researchers will come.
I'm not sure I'm cut out for a career in research. The pictures say revolution, but the words are coded, circumspect, dense. Or maybe that's me. I hesitate to ask about intentions, feeling the questions will make me sound stupid. But then, I decide to risk it. Sonalben, what were the goals of the Indian women's movement?
To change the world, nothing less. Really? See, movement, when you say it's a political thing.
Women in media group.
This is the one I was searching for. The documentation center mein hamesha laga
hua. Always keep friendship with old women. You never know what you will get.
When this letter came, about Mathura rape case judgment that four lawyers had sent. Two women made 50 copies of it and sent. I was one of the women who received that, and 49 women had turned up. It was a turning point in my life, because that is when I knew what it was to be a part of a political process, you know, being with others, working in public, not doing good privately, or standing for your own rights. That was also important, but that scene, you know, was very good. But I still don't crave for that, because how can 21 years, 22 years later, how can the same thing happen, you know? One woman said, in your time it was like this. It was a shocking statement. I said, this is not my time. There is this sort of feeling that we are new and we are, as I said, now that money is out of India, they study out of India, they settle out of India. If they live in India, they want to live as if they are not in India. And I'm not even referring to their food choices and clothes choices. You know? It is the indifference to what is India. This has happened. Now, that is bound to come within the movement also. Nobody understands the one thing, that you can't be part of women's movement or NGO about women without, for instance, reading up on women. I'm amazed, you know, that people don't read. They don't want to see what has gone into the debates about gender, about women's issues. Who are these biggest people? If you do anything else, you would have to read, you know. Here, just because you're a woman and you're associated with some women's work and so on, you think that you can then make statements on that.
The feminist movement said the personal is political. If the people we aspire to become, the places we can go, the things we dare to do are limited, it isn't just hard luck and individual ability, but a social pattern, a political structure that defines a place, a role, a right. These limits unravel when one woman turned to another and said, "Hey, let's talk about feminism."
Let's talk about equality, rights.
Let's talk about power, politics.
Let's talk about work,
equal pay.
Organizing.
Let's talk about sex,
gender.
Let's talk about freedom.
The feminist movement is not simply one of mobilizing an army to capture state power and establish a socialist society, but of changing relations between human beings here and now.
Feminism entails the fight not of women against men, but of women against an overall system of exploitation.
Feminism is a commitment to eradicating the ideology of domination, so that the self-development of people can take precedence over imperialism, economic expansion, and material desires.
We want to change the world, not simply to understand it.
This stuff is cool. I think I'm ready for the next level.
Any advocacy for the strategic use of concept woman presupposes an objective subject, having an attribute of the subject, having total mastery and calculability, thus denying the social processes which essentially mediates any construction.
Okay, guess it's time for a romance novel.
Are these original authors, you think?
Must be, huh?
Oh, wow. What is this now?
See what that is?
Gloria Steinem. Yeah, that's quite unusual.
Autograph. First couple of
news. Oh well, it's really crazy to find it here of all places.
Do you often come here? I've not been here for ages. Do you come here much?
No, I'm coming here after a long time, but I'm enjoying it. Except the crowds. Well, at the moment, I'm a freelance researcher. I'm trying to get funds to work on my PhD.
What's your PhD about?
It's looking at the conflict in Kashmir with a gender perspective. And it's also looking at the idea of security. And it's a critique of the whole idea of state-centric national security as compared to human security, which is inclusive and people-oriented.
The signs seem to point to it. Another feminist, I think. But how to know for certain? Perhaps I should just ask.
Do you work only on Muslim women's issues?
I don't work with only Muslim women. I work in the area of gender, and I've been looking in the area of women and Muslim communities. But at the same time, I mean, I would consider myself part of the women's movement.
Are you a feminist?
I am a woman and I am a feminist. There's no doubt about that. But I think that everybody has their own definition of feminism, and feminism has also been a very a much abused term, and it's also very relative. And I don't subscribe to the notion of feminism being something entirely to do with your personal life choices. I think it's a critical awareness of the world around you as a woman. And I would have that definition of feminism for me. And I hope that that definition of feminism, the political message of feminism, is not going to be diluted.
The reportage of history makes feminism seem a faraway thing. It doesn't suggest an ordinary encounter with a woman who says easily, "I'm a feminist." It doesn't promise the thrill of conversation, the moment of discovery, the transformation within which makes the political personal. Feminism seems like something you can aspire to, but are not likely to do. How How do we mark when and how something begins? Was the Indian women's movement born in 1884 because a very obstinate woman named Rakhmabai went off to England to become a doctor, defying a court order which said she couldn't leave a husband she didn't want? In 1979, when one angry letter from four lawyers against a Supreme Court ruling saying it was okay for a woman called Mathura to be raped because she wasn't a virgin set off a wave of national protest and changes in law? Or was it with an earlier law, banning sati, in 1829? Was it born from the conviction in Sarojini Naidu, who led a delegation asking for women's right to vote in 1919, 28 years before Indian independence? An important history to know. But will dates and times help us claim the future, or even the present?
You don't set out on a journey without a map. You need not be overwhelmed by history, but without it, you'll be adrift.
But I'm already there in a feminist life. And I don't need a map for the city I live in. I know its lanes, its speed breakers.
But do you know how they got there and who paid for them?
I've read the books, but I still feel like I'm vague about what happened. Except that one important feminist does not get along with another, so you have to watch what you say to whom.
There has been such a rich history. You know, you can't expect that just because we are women, we will magically dissolve all our differences and we will love each other from the word go. Of course we don't.
We had this huge differences. Communist parties said that gender issue will be resolved after revolution. And we insisted it becomes part of revolution, whatever. But it was not without respect to those women who had worked for better wages for women workers. We had a sense of history. We were answerable to these solid women, you know.
Don't you want to know what you're linked to? Know why you can do a PhD? Not live without desire? Walk away from violence? Own your own telephone?
To always learn from my mother's life. That doesn't seem like it's enough. To respect it, yes. To draw a lesson from it. See how it makes me what I am today, sure. But how to find a way to make it resonate in my own life?
History is anyway the history of a few upper-class women in Delhi.
Marx is too sharp. Perhaps you can't read any other language than English. It exists by other people in other languages.
No, that's not what Chamki means, I think. Of course we want to know about the many histories of different groups of women, but it's about the way in which history is told.
We know of the fight of the powerless to win a rightful power, but what about the history of what we have done with that power?
Reflection, not just documentation.
A different sort of record.
Somehow, we want to hear a history that is not only of oppression or achievement, like an extended political pamphlet. We'd like a history of conversations.
Of women who muddled through and led messy lives. Sort of like us.
So write that history. Read our books first, then reject them if you like. That history belongs to you too. Don't act like it's a preserve of someone else.
Yes, seek it out and claim it for your own.
All history books should be burnt and we should just start afresh.
Not sure if I'm ready for that yet, Anarchist Anne.
Sita! Sita!
You still look the way you did at 16.
Though, yeah, just look at you.
My daughter.
So sweet.
That's why we call her Sweetie.
Ajabita Sweetie, what do you want to be when you grow up?
I don't know, Auntie. Maybe a doctor or a teacher or maybe a feminist.
Your daughter wants to be a feminist. Don't get your knickers in a twist. Call moi. So, you want to be a feminist? Okay. Do you want to be ugly? Do you want to be unloved and alone?
Saw me standing alone.
Well? Do you want to be cold and hard-boiled?
No.
Feminist.
Let me go. I'm sorry.
Still wanna be a feminist?
Never!
Superman's school for ladies.
Go! eradication of feminism?
Don't worry.
Just hurry.
Call us
and be rescued.
I think women are great, but no, I'm not a feminist. I think that slight imbalance between the equality between the man and the woman should be maintained.
I am a feminist, but I don't hate feminists.
Yes, I am a feminist.
If feminism just means empty rhetoric, I don't really support it.
I think that men and women should have equal rights in all areas.
Basically, I'm very puzzled about what the definition of feminism means.
Yes, but I guess this whole definition thing, I'm not sure we need a definition, but if I'm not sure I'm a feminist. But yeah, I guess.
Do you know many people who don't want to call themselves feminists?
Yes, a lot of people had this resistance. I'm not a feminist. You will find that the most of them belong to the earlier generation. I mean, my generation. As I said, Alu Dastur, Usha Mehta. First and foremost, they saw themselves as members of the freedom generation. They had been part of the freedom movement. And they had accepted, taken constitutional equality in their stride. Like me, they had never thought of themselves as discriminated against. So, feminism was associated with people who felt themselves to be discriminated against, you see, as weak people. So that's why. That's why the participation in the investigation of the Committee on the Status of Women in India proved to be such a brain-shattering experience. Because it was a very big blow to one's self-perception. As a social scientist, as a teacher and as a woman, that I had remained so ignorant of and consequently indifferent to what was happening to the majority of women in this country. I mean, I used to have nightmares hearing my mother's and my father's voices. This is why we gave you all those opportunities to study. Itna hi sikha. Kya kaam pe lagaya? What happened to your sense of responsibility? I have heard my mother's voice in my dreams. What happened? To be apolitical for our generation was to be a non-Indian, was to be anti-democratic, a reactionary.
Why has that changed?
Movements have long roots. They take time. They take time to mature. They take time to expand.
To the first women's studies conference in Calicut in 1976.
The first Calicut conference, yeah.
What was it like?
Great. One of the important reasons is that it was just after the emergency, when many of us had been underground, Some were arrested, some were tortured, all that. There was just this feeling of so much of wonder that so many women could come together and women are talking about issues of importance, because you know, activists are not able to have the same kind of time to read and relate and theorize as academicians could. And the Calicut Women's Conference really brought together academicians and activists in a completely open way.
उठ जाग मेरी बहना चल साथ मेरी बहना तू मान मेरा कहना ये जुल्म नहीं सहना ये जुल्म नहीं सहना ये जुल्म नहीं सहना
एक पूरा वर्स मैंने गाया दोस्त
किसने लिखा था ये गाना
वी डिड आई डिड प्रवीण एंड आई
व्हेन
वंस ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम बॉम्बे टू चंडीगढ़ We were on the train, Ramla, he and I were travelling on the train. We had nothing to do, so we wrote a song. Today, I don't think people realise how difficult it was to be a feminist then. Where feminism at that point meant that people opposed the concept of equal rights. There were many representatives of left groups which said, what's patriarchy? I mean, how does it fit into the mode of production? But I think the important question would be, why is it that when I believed so strongly on gender issues, why did I go on to work with workers instead, and not just women, but also men and women? That also came out of a certain marginalization that was happening. You know, when we first formed the organization, there was, why do you need a women's organization? And then it came to like, women will work in women's organizations. Women will lead women. Women will talk about women's issues. Why? And we can lead men and women. We're same as everybody else. And so today, if I think about the fact that Gayatri and I, we are both leading an organization of textile workers, which is 90% male, and we don't have a problem, and they don't have a problem either. And that is important for us. Now you see, you go to any group, you go to a party, you go to a meeting, a public meeting, you go to a political gathering, you will see women getting together and start talking to each other, you know, wherever. And they all start to relate to each other very fast, and they start talking about things, and there's that kind of, you know, interest in each other. But that's not enough. It exists outside, but if you want to gather that into a socially changing movement, you need to put that together. Who's going to do it? It can't be some kind of spontaneous movement where people come together and sisterhood becomes, you know, like creates a revolution. It's not going to happen. There are many women who choose to live alone. There are many women who choose not to have kids. I'm not saying that that is the ideal thing. It's not as if, okay, if you don't choose to have kids, you're a feminist. I don't believe that. But I'm saying that you exercise a choice against the tide. To exercise a choice within the system is one thing, and to exercise a choice against the tide is another thing altogether. You are choosing outside of what society gives you as choices. You're making a choice which society really doesn't give you. Then there is a question of a movement. Do you see an alternative where women are making those choices and say, I want to be with them? Or you see an organization which says workers must fight for their rights and you say, I'll fight with them. Suppose those alternatives are not there, and this importance of organization and movements. When you see it, you say, I can do that.
Women's movement was on a roll, building groups, changing laws, challenging the attitudes of generations. And then everyone wanted to talk to the feminists, give them a benefit or two, protect them from something, or accuse them of not having women's real interests at heart. In a room full of voices, how do you identify the real feminist?
You must check out this website, dangerouswomen.com.
Does it have hot pictures?
Huh?
And what is this LOL you all keep writing?
Marxist Usha, it stands for laughing out loud, didn't you know?
ASL. ASL.
Some person is continuously sending me messages saying ASL.
Me too.
What does it mean?
Please. How long have you been on the internet?
It stands for age, sex, location.
Why does he want to know all this about me?
So he can decide whether to flirt with you or not.
And that will help him decide. How shallow.
Then what would you prefer him to ask?
My views on anything. Like we are discussing here.
If all this doesn't matter, then why does your ID declare your religion?
I thought the internet is the place where all these identities fall away. And we connect on the basis of something more fundamental.
That's what we thought in the movement. That identity as women brought us together. That we spoke for all women. But it was a mistake.
So you don't feel our identity as women is our primary identity?
It's our most visible identity. And we didn't always look beyond it to address the exact issues of, say, Muslim and Dalit women.
We learned the hard way through what happened with Shabanu or Bhavri Devi.
But don't you think sometimes that we have swung to the other extreme and that now everything is broken down to the specific identity of each woman?
Yep. Somehow it becomes about identity politics, not feminist politics.
Actually, the Muslim Personal Law Board called a meeting of various women after they had spelled out their terms and they had said that, you know, we don't want to talk about Shabanu, we don't want to talk about polygamy or triple talaq. I mean, then what is there to talk about? Why meet them? I mean, who are they? They are most unfeminist, you know. So to have any kind of dialogue with them is giving them more legitimacy.
You can't put a fence around and say nothing comes from outside.
Does negotiating with the mainstream have to compromise our feminism?
What is it that's common to us all? What we call feminism?
Equality, of course.
But which recognizes that people are different. And does not treat everyone like they start out with the same advantages.
Recognizing the way power functions.
Or malfunctions. You can't fight for your own respect and then oppress someone else.
But we had to recognize that we were also implicated. You know, you couldn't sit there as a middle-class housewife with a rich husband who gave you a driver and a car, which enabled you to be feminist, and then go home and not pay your cleaning woman the minimum wage that...
Yes, the personal is political.
You can't be a woman in power, like, say, Sadhvi Ritambara, encouraging violence, and then be called a feminist.
Or a Miss India, who has influence and money, and makes teenagers anorexic and depressed.
It's not just getting a little women's room. It's about imagining a different world.
There's more to life than what's convenient.
I think that that's also a challenge to reclaim, you know, the meaning of feminism.
And to have a good time doing it.
Again feminism. All lesbos in this room, what?
There are some lesbians here, Hot Rod.
And hetero women.
Speak for yourself. I'm bi.
Nice, na?
What was it that made you a feminist?
I think there are so many things that can work as that catalytic or transformative agent for you. For my mother, for example, who had grew up with a kind of innate feminism, but she didn't necessarily know it. It was just seeing a young woman being burned to death by her in-laws. And that just catalyzed something in her. And then she, that was what turned her into a feminist.
I don't even know consciously when I became a feminist. I think it's just something that I grew into. I don't think I had a dream or a utopia. I knew what was wrong. I knew what I did not want. But I didn't quite know what I did want. And I think that is the way that many feminists define up till now. Because we've been a bit short on utopias and dreams. We know the negatives of what should not be there, but we don't easily know the positives. It hasn't been, you know, a kind of utopic vision out there, some general ideals. It's been very concretely, we want changes here, we want changes there. I think that's been both one of the strengths and one of the weaknesses.
So, would you say that's the reason why most younger women are unable to identify with feminism? That there's no overall vision? And does that make you sad?
But tell me, let me ask answer that question of yours by posing a question to you. What can you do about this? Would you rather that they had not gained from feminism, or that they use their position of having gained from it to reject it? You see, I think this is the reality we have to live with. Because in any movement, there are people who will benefit from that movement, but who will not then want to own it, because they have found a balance of taking the benefits of that and taking what they want of the other kind of life. I mean, that they don't want to recognize that if they do both, they are compromising. And we're seeing this shift where the right to purchase X or Y washing machine or X or Y cold drink is now given as much importance as the right to have an abortion, the right to control over your body, the right to marry or not marry, and so on and so forth. I think there's a lesson there for us feminists, you know, because we have talked about these very things as our ideals, as the things that are our most cherished things. The right to choose, agency or control over your own activities, the access to the public space, and so on and so forth. It's all there now. It's all there, but we suddenly realize, but this is not what we meant. You know, so we can't now, I mean, I think we really have to think, because we can't go to these women and say, but hey, we didn't mean this kind of agency. We meant something else. We didn't mean this kind of control. We didn't mean coming out into the public space in this way. I think this is one of the biggest challenges to those of us who see ourselves as feminists. How do we deal with this?
Can you tell me something interesting about Valentine's Day? Why do you think it is important for you? Otherwise, every day is important for those who are in love.
So fearless, I couldn't resist. I ended up meeting obnoxious hunk again for a date.
And?
Actually, I had a good time. He's silly and funny. Although his opinions on globalization make me want to scream.
Never hurts to have your opinion challenged. Keeps you sharp.
He is smart. Although sometimes I wonder if he's treating me like a child.
I once knew a guy who kept ruffling my hair.
Bad sign?
No, actually. He just had to stop playing Big Brother out of habit.
Sad ending?
Not really.
I hate sad endings. But I've learned the hard way. You can't change someone with your love.
But sometimes, their love for you can make people change. If they can risk really loving you.
You have a lot of hope, Fearless.
We need hope. And risk. And love in unexpected places.
But how do you get past the packaged lines about respecting women to what's really inside?
Not sure I can handle what's really inside.
Fearless! I want to invent a litmus which will turn red when it sees a fake agenda.
Yes, Madam Junkie Curie. A female intuition chip to get to the real truth.
X-ray vision.
Hey there! Strong women giving you a hard time. Got equal rights, but not getting any action, eh? Then it's time you got yourself a point of view. It's cool, it's new, it's better than X-ray vision. It's the male gaze goggle. See the magic before your eyes. Just 2 minutes and you get to the essence of things. Can't afford plastic surgery? Have no fear. Even you can be perfect. In a flash, become the girl of his dream.
Darling, chalo na.
And a master of the universe. Life will never look the same once you have worn the male gaze goggle. Available in 2 sleek models, his and her.
साहेब आमच्या समोरच्या बंगल्यामध्ये एका बाईला पेटून गेलं साहेब.
झेंडे साहब जो फिल्म की स्क्रिप्ट आपने लिखी उसकी कहानी का आइडिया आपको कैसा आया?
ओ बहुत से केसेस ऐसे होते थे कि ये मारना जलाना, लव किया तो उसको शादी दूसरे के साथ किया तो उसको ख़त्म करना, उसके बाद भी ऐसे बहुत से केसेस हम देखा कि संबंध है, लव है और कोई देख लिया तो फिर वो औरत पलटी खा जाती थी, मतलब ये देखा हमारी इज्जत जल जाएगी, ऐसे बहुत से केसेस होते थे। तो बहुत आदमी के ऊपर भी उसको भी भुगतना पड़ता है, उसको अंदर जाना पड़ता है। मैं सोचा कि इसके ऊपर कुछ अपन लिखे, ये समाज के लिए कुछ लेसन होवे, समाज के लिए कुछ बोध होवे। जिस लड़की से मैं चाहा, जिस लड़की से प्यार किया, बहुत प्यार किया, दुनिया में किसी ने नहीं किया होगा इतना मैं किया था उसके साथ। फिर वो शादी, बस वो तो जरा अमीर था, पैसे वाला था, तो उसको लगा शायद कि ये पुलिस अपने को क्या दे सकता है, तो बस उसके शादी में गया, उसको गिफ्ट दिया, वापस आया, बहुत रोया, सुसाइड करने का सोचा, फिर वे सब दोस्तों ने बचा लिया मुझे। वो प्यार करने वाले हर इंसान ने वो देखना चाहिए, ऐसा नहीं कि खाली महाराष्ट्रीय लोगों ने, और जो जो ये फिल्म देखेंगे तो वो जो आज ये हो रहा है, ये प्रेसी को जलाया, उसको मार डाला, वो ख़त्म हो जाएगा, मैं ये दावा करता हूँ। हाँ जरूर, उतना लिखा है मैं उस ताकत से।
लग्नापूर्वीच्या प्रियकराशी प्रेमाचं नाटक करून त्याच्या भावनांची खेळून या मुली सहजपणे एखाद्या श्रीमंत मुलाचा हात धरून भोल्यावर चढतात आणि मग अशा दुभंगलेल्या मनाचे तरुण अंमली पदार्थांच्या आहारी तरी जातात किंवा गुन्हेगारी क्षेत्राकडे वळतात। मिलॉर्ड, जर हे सगळं थांबावसे वाटत असेल तर प्रथम अशा तरुणीने सुधारायला हवं,
नहीं जाएगी कभी भी, कितना भी कुछ भी हो, वो जो उसको प्यार ही करेगी, उसके साथ तो अपना प्यार निभाएगी, उसके साथ शादी करेगी।
स्त्री ही पातिव्रत्याची, वात्सल्याची, ममतेची पवित्र मूर्ती है, तिची फक्त पूजाच करायची असते, विटंबना नाही।
पूजा जरूर करना चाहिए क्योंकि वो पूजे का लायक ही है।
फिर भी आदमी लोग अपनी बीवी को मारते हैं।
बराबर है, वो बच्ची औरत होती है, कुछ नहीं पकाया खाना बराबर, काम से जब थक के आता है आदमी तो खाना रेडी होना चाहिए, नहीं किया तो एक आप झापट क्या होगा, मार लेगा झापट। वो मारने से प्यार हो जाता है, प्यार से मारते, कोई गुस्से से नहीं मारते।
As a definition of domestic violence in the bill recognizes it only if it is habitual assault. Also, according to Section 4, Clause 2 of the bill, if a man beats his wife to protect his property, it is not domestic violence, but a part of his right to defend himself.
हिंदुस्तान की हमारी अपनी संस्कृति, हमारे अपने जो विचार हैं, और परिवार को कायम रखते हुए हमें प्रोटेक्ट करना है, परिवार को तोड़ने की कहीं ना कहीं कहीं से हम।
पिताजी, मैं विलायत में शादी क्यों करने लगा, मैं तो कर भी कैसे सकते हो, तुम्हारे वंश का संबंध श्री रामचंद्र के सूर्य वंश से, जानते हो तुम्हारी शादी के लिए मैंने क्या क्या ख्वाब देखे।
Hey, my organization has put up an online petition asking for more ladies' buses for the university to combat eve teasing.
Chumki, I don't know if I want to sign that. I'm bored of all this protectionist attitude.
Why? You enjoy sexual harassment.
Thanks for the support, Attila. The sisterhood lives.
The law has to tackle the crime, not just put a lid on it. What will change with this?
Men aren't going to change overnight. So till then, at least girls can travel safely to college.
Boys have to learn that no means no.
It's not so easy for many girls to have the courage to say no.
Can we just talk about the girls who want to say yes?
Sorry?
I don't mean yes to sexual harassment. Whenever we talk about sex and women, it's about rape, assault. If we only teach women to fear sex, then how are we supposed to feel good and free about it?
No one is stopping you from any lifestyle.
See, immediately, I'm a bad girl with a lifestyle. Where's the room for eroticism within us?
It's okay for Western women to talk about sexual liberation. In our country, there are many other problems to solve.
Yeah, no sex, please. We are Indian. When I watched movies as a kid, I thought Indians don't kiss, only white people do.
You know, there was a way in which we like people to attend to us as minds. I'm bright, I'm not a woman. So it's distracting yourself from your body all the time. I think the most exhilarating moment for me when I felt there was something wonderful to be a woman is when my lover first made love to me. So that moment was so exciting and so wonderful. I felt glorious.
Ooh, now we are talking.
But you know, even when I try to talk about it, there's this silence from men who won't share their confusions. So then I feel ashamed of mine.
There has to be a dialogue with men. They are also confused by us.
It is not the duty of women to see that men understand.
We're not talking of men on the street. We're talking of the men in our lives.
Am I the only one? Or does everyone feel pressured to have an orgasm during sex? Hello, where's everybody?
Anne, no one can understand this font you are using.
Yeah, right. And if I talk about masturbation, will they all log off?
There are ample amount of laws in India. If a woman complains in the women's cell, if she goes to the police, definitely the guy is going to get screwed up. But nobody has the guts to do this.
There are many different organizations and they have to take steps and they are already taking
It has
steps.
Been more than 100 years after the establishment of the Brahma Samaj by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. He took this step to abolish sati system. And it has been taken so many
years. Just I want to say ki meri shaadi ho rahi hai aur aisi ladki se ho rahi hai jiska first husband jo tha wo fauji hai. फौजी था वो मर गया उसका एक बच्चा भी है फिर भी मैं उससे शादी कर रहा हूँ क्यों क्योंकि उसे मेरी जरूरत है एक चीज की जरूरत है
ये जरूरत है ऐसी वर्कशॉप्स ऐसे डिस्कशंस लड़कियों को आज की डेट में बहुत ज़्यादा साहस और शक्ति तो देती हैं परिस्थितियों से लड़ने के लिए ऐसा मैं समझती हूँ
हमने ये भी कहा है कि तुम्हें अधिकार मिलने चाहिए लेकिन हमने ये भी बताया कि तुम्हें कर्तव्य होने चाहिए अगर हम कर्तव्य नहीं करेंगे तो अधिकार से तो फिर वो तो डायरेक्शन गलत ले ली जाएगी
मैं ये नहीं कहती कि अन्याय को सहते हुए टॉलरेट करते जाओ एक पर्टिकुलर लेवल की टॉलरेंस होनी चाहिए सहनशीलता होनी चाहिए घर जोड़ने की अच्छी क्षमता होनी चाहिए एक अच्छी गाइडेंस प्रोवाइड कर सके नारी
हम चाहेंगे कि किसी की उंगली हमारे ऊपर ना उठे हम ऐसा कोई काम ना करें कोई दूसरा ही अगर वो हम कभी कभी ऐसा है कि दूसरा तो उंगली उठाता रहता है हम अपने ऊपर भी क्वेश्चन करें कि नहीं हम जो काम करें वो ठीक नहीं है
ये लो ऊपर ही देख लो आप
मुंह में टॉफी खिलाई जा रही है
गल्लेबाजी हो रही है वहाँ पर देखो आप खुद ही देखो
मैम ये क्या बात
है
आप
कैच करो
आओ मैम आप लिमिट तक आओगे यहाँ से लड़कियाँ आप आगे आएंगे ना लिमिट तक आए तो ठीक है अब इस लिमिट तक आगे आएंगे तो फिर नाम
अनलिमिटेड हो जाती है अनलिमिटेड हो जाती है उसके बाद उनके साथ गलत होता है जब गलत होता है तो लड़कों को दोषी बताएंगी
भविष्य में तो कोई बात नहीं दोस्त को नहीं कुछ भी नहीं है इसमें तो इसमें क्या बात है
ये कोई बड़ी बात
ये कोई बड़ी बात नहीं है अपने दोस्त को नहीं खिलाते
जैसे अब आपकी एक
चीज और क्यों लड़कियाँ अपने आप को अगर उन्होंने हाफ स्लीव मतलब ब्लाउज पहना है तो कट स्लीव पहन लेती हैं क्यों अगर साड़ी पहनी है तो मिनी स्कर्ट पहन लेती हैं उसमें वो अपने आप को ज़्यादा अच्छा समझती हैं लड़का है अगर आप लड़कों को देखेंगे अगर उसने अगर हाफ शर्ट पहन रखी है तो वो कोशिश करेगा कि फुल स्लीव शर्ट हो मतलब मेंटेलिटी है कि अपने आप को पूरा कपड़े में कंफर्टेबल समझता है लड़का लड़की जो है वो अपने आप को जितना मतलब अंग दिखाएगी उतना अच्छा मतलब उतने अच्छी तरीके से प्रेजेंट समझती है कि मेरी तरफ अट्रैक्शन होगा लोगों का
पार्टियों में जाती है छोटे छोटे कपड़े पहन के इसीलिए जाते हैं कि लड़के लड़कियां जिनका भी हो ध्यान हमारी तरफ ज्यादा जाए
जैसे आपके सामने एक रसगुल्ला रखा है तो आपको खाने का तो लालच आएगा ही आएगा
रसगुल्ले का कंपैरिजन कर रहे
हो आप जैसे क्लास में से पानी पीने जा रहे हैं तो भी हमें अपनी पार्टनर की जरूरत है
पानी पीने जा रहे हैं तो हमें किसी के साथ की ज़रूरत है, मतलब हम अकेले जाके पानी भी नहीं पी सकते थे।
मैम अब टैलेंट सर्च हुआ था मैम, उसमें हमने पार्टिसिपेट किया, हमने डांस किया मैम, जिस सॉन्ग पर हमने डांस किया ना मैम हमने का, और उसी सॉन्ग के नाम से मैम हम कॉरिडोर में से जा रहे हैं तो हमें उसी के ऊपर मैम कमेंट्स दिए जा रहे हैं कि इसने उसके ऊपर डांस किया था, इसको कमेंट्स मिले। मैम ये नहीं कि हमारा डांस बुरा था मैम, फर्स्ट प्राइज़ विन किया था। अब हमारे कॉलेज की मैम एक लड़की को मैम क्लास में से टीचर्स के सामने उठा कर ले गए थे बाहर से, मैम क्या कर लिया मैम वो लड़की, उस लड़की ने क्या कर लिया
मैम। एक ऐसा एग्जांपल था जब कॉलेज थोड़ा शांत हो चुका था, शायद क्लासेस ऑफ हो चुकी थी, एक लड़की किसी वजह से रुक गई थी, लड़कों ने लिटरली उसको पकड़ के उसके यहाँ काटा, दे बिट हर, यहाँ काटा, पता नहीं कहाँ कहाँ उसको काटा, एंड शी वॉज, उसको इंजेक्शंस लगवाने पड़े। आप सोचिए
अगर एक लड़की मैम, सात आठ लड़कियाँ मैम एक लड़की के ऊपर गिर रहे हैं तो क्या कर लेगी वो मैम, उस भीड़ भड़के में वो कुछ भी नहीं कर सकती मैम। एंड में वही सिचुएशन आनी है मैम, घर तक पहुँच जाएंगे, डेली आएंगे, पीछे और क्या कर लेंगे।
पेरेंट्स कहेंगे बैठ
जाओ मैम, पेरेंट्स कहेंगे अगर वो नहीं मानते तुम मान जाओ, तुम घर बैठ जाओ।
पापा कहेंगे हाँ ठीक है तुम ही कोविड के लिए कह रही थी, आप बैठ के कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंस कर लो। वी हैव टू लिव अ लाइफ अकॉर्डिंग टू देम बिकॉज we don't feel like fleeing, we don't feel like being independent, because if we are independent on the at the cost of some other person's happiness, then that independence can never grant us the happiness which we deserve.
But then if they are happy at the cost of your independence, then do they deserve it?
See, sacrifice is divine and sacrifice is always paid, and I feel that feminism, I feel that females, they are the most powerful essence of sacrifice.
We don't want to flee.
Chumki, do you know if there's a word for the fear of freedom, like claustrophobia, agoraphobia and the like?
Yeah, it's called patriarchy.
Are there those who fear freedom? And who am I to say they are wrong? What's wrong, after all, with wanting to be loved? With suiting others while you suit yourself? With wanting to belong? To turn the smile on and the questions off about what's fair and not fair? Because isn't everything fair in love? And when you've done the right thing, drawn the circle with a pink felt pen around doubt and desire, then why do you still seem so alone? Can you tell me, Bhabhi?
ये आपने लिया ये सब आप आपको बुलाया जाता है
आंटी के साथ जाती हूँ मैं कौन सा प्रोफेशनल हूँ मेरे को कहाँ कैमरा मैं
तू कह मैंने लॉ करना है मैंने कहा ये बहुत बढ़िया लड़का मिल गया मुझे कहती है तो लॉ तो फिर नहीं हो पाएगा और लड़के तो आ ही जाएंगे जो मेरे नसीब में मैंने कहा नहीं मरवानी थी मरवा दी मुझे तो यही है मैंने मरवाई अपनी बच्ची चाहे कोई कुछ भी कहता रहे लड़का मैंने देखा था उसने तो नहीं देखा वो तो कुछ नहीं जानते थे मैंने 21 साल केस लड़ा है कहने को होते हैं 21 साल 6 महीने बाद उसको सजा हुई तो ये सब कहने लगे 7 साल की सजा हुई तो ये सब मुझे कहने लगे चलो आंटी कुछ तो हुआ मगर 2 महीने बाद हाई कोर्ट ने बेल दे दिया
जब ये सब होता है और आप कोर्ट में जाते हो आपको गुस्सा नहीं आता है
तो बहुत ज़्यादा आता है गुस्सा आने के लिए मैं तो कहती हूँ रो पड़ती थी और शाबाश है शक्तिशाली की एक स्टाफ का मैं कहती थी क्यों मेरे पीछे पड़े हुए तुम्हें क्या तुम तो शक्तिशाली में बैठ गए ना मेरी बेटी मरती ना ये शक्तिशाली बनती मेरी बेटी मारी गई है और नहीं मरनी चाहिए मगर मर तो नहीं है मर रही है
हम फिर उनको लेटर डाल देंगे कि आपकी वाइफ हमारे पास आई, हमने एक तरफा बात सुनी, आपसे भी सुनना चाहते हैं। फिर हम दूसरा लेटर थोड़ा सा जोर का डालेंगे कि आप आए नहीं, हम आगे कार्रवाई करने जा रहे हैं। फिर हम नोटिस दिलवाएंगे।
मेरी बेटी को दहेज के लिए जला दिया था, मार दिया था जान से। वहाँ से मुद्दा शुरू हुआ मेरा। लेकिन मेरे मन के अंदर उससे पहले से भी कुछ था कि जो मैं चाहती थी, अगर मेरे पड़ोस में कोई लड़ाई झगड़ा हो जाता था तो मैं उनके बीच में भी बोलने लगती थी। तो मेरे घर वाले हमेशा मेरे से बोला करते थे, दूसरों के घर में जाकर दखल अंदाजी करने की बहुत गंदी आदत है। लेकिन जब बेटी को जान से मार दिया और बेटी के मसले को लेकर चले तो बहुत सी औरतों से जुड़े। लड़की का कौन सा है? ये कहाँ लड़की है और ये कहाँ बच्चा?
वो कहती मुझे कुछ भी कमी नहीं, मेरा दिल ही नहीं लगता है। माँ भी पूछती उसकी, तुझे तेरी सास डांटती क्या? तेरा मियाँ कुछ कहता कोई कुछ? अरे मुझे कोई भी कुछ नहीं कहता, मेरा तो दिल ही नहीं चाहता है रहने को। मुझे तो यो आदमी ना अच्छा लगता।
जब तुम्हारी बहू नाराज है, हम चलते हैं तुम्हारे साथ, हम बात करेंगे उनसे और हम उनसे पूछेंगे कि बेटा तुम्हें क्यों नहीं यहाँ अच्छा लगता है। अगर परिवार पसंद नहीं है तो उसका कोई हिसाब है, तुम अपने शौहर को लेकर कहीं अलग रह सकते हो। और अगर तुम्हें शौहर पसंद नहीं है फिर तो ये सोचना पड़ेगा कि तुम अपनी ज़िंदगी को मौत में ना बदलने के बजाय तुम अपनी इनसे तलाक लेकर अपनी आज़ादी ज़िंदगी जैसे गुजारना चाहती हो वैसे गुजारो। वो चली गई थी 3 महीने तक, वो अपने घर रही,
चार महीने
अपने घर थी। फिर उसको ये लोग ले आए।
अरे
उससे बात करें, वो चाहता क्या है उससे, हमारा मतलब
उससे दिली मोहब्बत है। उससे
सारे मर्दों को दिली मोहब्बत होती है, समझ गई ना तुम? दिली मोहब्बत होती है। ये नारीवाद सोच नहीं आती, ना नारी आंदोलन का एक अंधियाव आता, ना हमारे पर लगते, ना हम उड़ते, ना हम यहाँ तक पहुँचते। हम क्या जानते थे किसको कहते? हम अपनी माँ को भी अपने जुल्मों का शिकार देखा हमने, फिर हमारे ऊपर जो जुल्म हो रहे थे हम उन्हें वो भी सह रहे थे। लेकिन जब नारी आंदोलन का एक तूफान आया तो उस तूफान में जाने को किसका दिल नहीं चाहेगा? सभी का दिल चाहेगा। जिन लोगों ने बहुत कुछ घरों में सहा है तो वो तो बाहर निकलने का ताले तोड़ने की भी कोशिश करेगा।
Our movement had an impact on every dimension of women's lives. Health, education, work, family.
Golden past is very dangerous politics, you know.
Come on. Our independent women's groups did much more than so many of the NGOs today.
Groups or NGOs are the byproducts of feminism. They are not feminism themselves.
Feminism is not only making private choices. What you do in public life is what really counts.
In a 9-to-5 job with an organization, you provide a service, like a doctor in a hospital. Valuable, but you're a functionary, not necessarily a feminist.
Fearless, most feminist agendas are still to be fulfilled. And you want to sit and split hairs?
There are things agendas don't address.
Like?
Like, though love is a relationship of power, it is also a relationship of love. That we asked people to choose the lone path, but we didn't offer a new meaning of alone.
All this confusion is becoming an excuse for doing nothing.
And has sisterhood become an excuse for just doing the same old things? You were women who broke away from families, husbands, jobs for what you believed in. But did you do it only to seek refuge in another kind of structure? And do you hesitate to question it?
You need to study the politics of public action, strategy.
It seems, in strategy and politics, you can't be seen as not having all the answers. It's more important to issue a statement with the group than to speak the truth alone.
Maybe we need to exchange official dialogue with real conversations. We guard our power too fearfully. We shut out the doubts.
You need to have power to fight power.
we set out to see beyond power, to name the unspoken, disguised places where power is misused.
What is the framework you are offering?
Not sure. Maybe it's silence we need, not strategy. New answers, not quick answers.
Fearless, feminism isn't only about having the answers. It's about having a way to ask questions.
So it's not as if this is this ocean which is going to swallow you and turn you into something that it is. It is an ocean in which you dive and find the pearl that you're looking.
Just what are you getting at?
We committed to the principles of honesty and questioning. We didn't join some army, is what we are getting at.
And it's about how people take these principles out into the world. Not about the movement, but movement in the sense of change.
Are you saying we should disband?
If that's where our questioning leads us.
Yes. And will the real postmodern civil libertarian fearless please stand up?
It's no point talking to you. I'm going.
No, don't go fearless.
No, don't go fearless. We'll all miss you.
We are just having a conversation and you are taking it personally now.
In the golden days of yore, women were women, men were men. God was in his heaven, and feminists easy to deal with. If you knew the classic signs, breathing fire, hysteria, bra burning, home breaking. But times have changed, and feminists are everywhere. Driving cars, eating ice cream, even having babies. There could be one in your home. That is why you need the Misogyny Feminist Detector. With a unique beeper feature. A friend of the family. Man's trusty guide. Don't let normal behavior fool you. Let your misogyny find the feminists in our midst and bring back a cleaner, more wholesome world.
Dial M for misogyny. Call now.
Hello? Kya aapke kamre mein koi rehta hai?
I'm not gonna be weak. Yes, I'm gonna be strong.
Hide within this at one level, yes. On the other hand, some people are striving for a gay identity. Some people are actually proud of being gay and want to publicize that.
I'm saying, if you're proud of it and you want to come out and make a political statement, I'm saying please do.
What you mean to say that two women walking hand in hand in the street, people look at you, what are you doing? What's up, Subbalakshmi? What's happening? You know, it's like that.
I wouldn't care because I believe that being homosexual is okay. Right. So if you believe that being homosexual is okay, it should even be wrongly okay. Being believed that you are homosexual shouldn't be a problem. Stop clapping.
That kind of respect for other women's experiences and other women who choose to have a certain way of life for themselves is something you have to come to. It's not like imposing your decision ever. Feminism, you have to be very critical of yourself. The moment you're passing a judgment, you have to be open to the question that, am I judging correctly? Transformation alone is no transformation at all. You have to transform people around you. Otherwise, it's just nothing. You're this isolated person who's transformed, and what big difference does that make?
I guess that's why I'm feminist now, because I'd like to believe I'm part of that movement which is struggling for that equality with respect to women.
But I really, really don't want to end up just living a politically correct life in my life kind of thing. I want to be out there and doing something. When you're just trying to get clear about your politics and trying to figure it out, Maybe you become closed for a while. I saw that happen to me last year. I used to get angry, like, you know, violently angry that at stuff that's going on around me. And then if there's someone who's going to come and say, I'm going to marry her after third year, you know, I wouldn't give her a chance. You know, I would say, can't you see, good morning, kind of a thing, you know, and that'll be like the first time when we're meeting, and she wouldn't dare to come and speak to me again. She's like, she's a weirdo, she doesn't want to get married, you know, she's mad, she must be lesbian or something, you know, something like that, and she'll go off. So that's like the end of it all. Now all this feminism, Marxism, kuch nahi, end of the day you're like, you know, one person, two people,
hello,
and you're like, whatever, hello, where is my friend circle, kind of a thing. So I'm kind of sure now, after figuring out for like a week now, that it's a time thing, and that it is going to pass after a while, and that I am going to learn to look at people for who they are and show me also who I am and just be, you know.
I was thinking about it, it's so funny. She's just talking about generally something, and she's like, it's okay to be single, it's okay to be double as well. And I thought there is no terminology as double, it's just single, as if by default you're supposed to be double or something, or more than two. You're supposed to be family, you're supposed to be society, you're not single.
And how will you end up?
Double, single, double, single, single, double, single, single, double, double, double.
No, yes. I might end up being double, yeah, forever. I think I might. I mean, I'm capable. Even a choice of deciding to be a feminist is like so, so serious, and it's a huge, big responsibility. It's like president of India, you know? If you're really serious about it and if you're committed to it, I think it's a huge choice.
It's been one of those times. I've been meaning to write to Chamki, but it seems important to be alone, to wonder about choosing a kind of life. I do mean to write to her though and ask her, do you think feminism is something we pointed to and chose? Or was it something that grew a little more, each time our minds were not closed and our hearts were open?
Suddenly a thing like feminism comes in. It changes my dimension of thinking. I get a certain mixed feelings now, whether to accept it, mend my ways, or to change, or to just shrug it off and say that, yeah, women are like that, they're fighting. As long as I am a boy, fortunately I'm a boy, so let me be happy. There are some who directly question me, why are you wasting your youth and energy being in the church? Such a fine boy, why don't you choose to be like other boys outside? Like, we have this life only once. And just living like others, in the sense like you're born, brought up, study and get a job, get married, have grandchildren, and suddenly you find yourself you are dead. I thought, instead of living life like this, I think I should contribute something to this world. And today I do question even the church that I am in. The Pope is always chosen a male. Until today, women have not been ordained as priests. I have spoken about it to my colleagues. Certainly I have not questioned my superiors yet. I will do it one day when I am in a position to question. If not possible, I might even choose to be different. I wouldn't be afraid or hesitate to turn back and say goodbye to this and take a different direction.
Where have you been? I thought you decided to leave the chat room after the fight last time.
Oh, no. I can't leave even if I never log on, you know.
You're tied to us for life.
With an umbilical cord. Married to the mob.
I was just thinking of mailing you. I found a line for your wall.
My wall is more than full, but I could use a good line any day.
It's by Marcel Proust. He says, "The journey of discovery lies not in seeking new landscapes, but in having new eyes."
Hmm. Hey, I've got something for you too. It's by a historian called Theodore Zeldin. The conclusion I draw from the history of slavery is that freedom is not just a matter of rights to be enshrined in law. The right to express yourself also leaves you with the need to decide what to say, to find someone to listen, and to make your words sound beautiful.
Fearless, can I say something?
Yeah, sure.
That was spoken like a true feminist.
Did you doubt I was one?
I thought you did.
Ah, you've got me again. Can I say something? Thank you for the compliment.
मुझे वाद का मतलब नहीं पता।
नारी का मतलब?
नारी तो नारी। औरतों के हक क्या होते हैं? ये तो नहीं पता क्या होते हैं औरतों के हक। लेकिन अपनी ज़िंदगी जीना ही एक हक होता है।
The feminists are out there in the countryside organizing.
Fighting for their land rights, fighting for their families, fighting for their passion. With respect to women, especially women.
Brain-shattering experience.
Women seeing themselves as whole, their bodies, their minds, their spirits.
सबसे पहले नंबर में हम इंसान, 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 इंसान.
The kind of person you are, the kind of person you become, the kind of person you want to be.
Hasne ka adhikar. How do you separate the oppression and the love? How do you have love with equality?
It's gone way, way, way beyond.
Oh Lord.
It's become very long, I agree.